Good morning, friends. Today, I am going to explain substitution method through this video. Before starting, let us quickly revise some basic concepts which you have already studied in standard 9. You all know linear equation in two variables. I'll give an example. Example 3x minus 7y equal to 5. This equation is called a linear equation in two variables. X and y, they are two variables and their degree is 1. So, it is called a linear equation in two variables. Correct? Now, what is 3 and 7? Here, 3 is coefficient of x. 3 is called coefficient of x. And 7, now 7 is having negative sign. So, we have to take that negative sign along with it. So, minus 7 is called coefficient of y. Correct? These things you have already learned. Now, let me show you how to express this equation in x form or y form. Now, x form. To express in x form, I will keep 3x in LHS and take minus 7y to RHS. So, when I take minus 7y to RHS, it will become plus 7y. So, x equal to 5 plus 7y upon 3. So, this is your x form. Similarly, you can convert into y form also. Now, y form of this equation will be, in y form, we want y. We don't want minus y. So, let us take this minus 7y to RHS so that it will become positive. So, 3x minus 5 equal to 7y. Since I have taken 7y there, 5 I brought it here. 5 was positive, so it became negative. So, now 3x minus 5 upon 7 equal to y. If you want to keep 7y in RHS only, then you can do this way also. See. Minus 7y equal to 5 minus 3x. So, y equal to 5 minus 3x upon minus 7. Now, we don't keep denominator to be negative. So, this sign has to be taken up. So, it will become 3 minus 5 upon 7. So, ultimately the answer comes out to be same. So, this is the easiest way. So, I always suggest my students to do it this way. Whenever the variable's coefficient is negative, take that variable to the other side so that it automatically becomes positive. So, understood, student? Now, we will come to our substitution method. Now, substitution method. Substitution methods involve four steps. The first step is express one of the variable in terms of other. That is what we have learned now, how to express in x form or y form. Then second step is substitute this value in the other equation and convert it into a linear equation in one variable. Third step, solve that equation and find the value of the other variable. And then substitute this other variable and find the value of the first variable. So, these are the four steps. Now, I will explain these steps using a example. Let me take an example. Solve linear equation 7x minus 15y equal to 2 and x plus 2y equal to 3. So, this is our question. We have to solve by substitution. For solution, first write the equation and number them. 7x minus 15y. Number it as 1. X plus 2y equal to 3. Number it as 2. Now, from any one of this equation, I will express in x form or y form. Now, for expressing in x form or y form, if there is coefficient 1 in any of the variable, that equation will be preferable or easy. So here I can see in equation 2, I have x with coefficient 1. So I will take from equation 2. So I am expressing equation 2 in x form. So it is what? X equal to 3 minus 2y. Now number this as 3. Later on I will tell you why I have numbered it as 3. Now substitute this. This is our first step. Express one of the variable in terms of other. So I have expressed one variable in terms of other from any one of this equation. Correct? Now I am second step. Substitute this value in the other equation. Now I have used equation 2. I will be using equation 1. So put x equal to 3 minus 2y in equation number 1. So in 1, wherever x is there, you can see x, there I will be putting this. So it will become 7 into 3 minus 2y minus 15y equal to 2. So this is our second step, substituting the value in other variable and converting into linear equation. Now if you check this, it is a linear equation in one variable because there is the other variable x is not there. Correct? So this is linear equation in variable y. Now let us go to the third step. Now let us solve this and find the value of y. So 7, 3s are 21, minus 14y, minus 15y equal to 2. Now, like terms here, 14y minus 15y equal to 2 minus 21. So minus 29y equal to minus 19. Minus, minus gone. So y equal to 19 upon 29. Here I completed the third step, that is solve the equation and find the value of the other variable. So in which variable I expressed, I got the value of other variable y. Now the last step, this variable's value you can substitute in any of the three equation. That is why I have numbered this as 3. Because substituting this in third will be easy because I will directly get x. So now put y in equation 3. So this will give me what? X equal to 3 minus 2 into 19 upon 29. So this is 3 minus 38 upon 29. So I have to take LCM. So it will be 87 minus 38 upon 29. So it is 49 by 29. Correct? Therefore, now write x order pair. In the order pair, when we are writing, we will write x first. So x is how much? 49 by 29 and y is 19 by 29 is the solution. I hope all of you understood.